Netflix, an amazing source of entertainment. This platform has made over $29 billion in revenue and currently has over 220 million users. So it's safe to say that when it comes to entertainment, Netflix is definitely up there. Netflix is of course known for its very popular franchises such as Stranger Things, Cobra Kai, 13 Reasons Why, and the list goes on. But today we're going to be talking about two specific shows, and these are actually very, very popular and they are doing very, very well on Netflix. Those being The Witcher and Cyberpunk Edgerunners. Now this isn't going to be a video specifically going over what these shows are about and sort of a guide to these shows or anything like that. It's not really going to be a video like that, but it's more just going to be sort of a discussion about how CD Projekt RED have worked so well with Netflix. But just before we do get into all of that, please be sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any content just like this. Are you interested in starting your very own Discord server, but you just simply don't know where to start? Well, I've got you covered. I've been using Discord daily for many, many years now, and in that time I've created and managed many servers, some of which have achieved over 5,000 active members. I've worked with YouTubers with over 150,000 subscribers and even cryptocurrency organizations. So whatever the server may be, I can confidently say that I'll be able to create and even manage an active server for your community. These servers will include really popular features and a very professional design. And if you want the best of the best, I can even throw in your very own custom Discord bot. So if you are interested in getting started or have any questions, then hit the link in description or the pinned comment that will take you straight to my Fiverr page. Now, CD Projekt RED is a company known for its Witcher franchise and the Cyberpunk 2077 title. Now, the Witcher franchise is absolutely massive and it has been very, very successful. It started off as books and then it went into games and then it went into a TV series. When it came to the launch of Cyberpunk 2077, it's safe to say that it was rough. It really didn't go down well at all. But the game has definitely improved a fair amount since then, and since the launch of Cyberpunk 2077, we actually got a series related to Cyberpunk, and that being Cyberpunk Edgerunners. And on the Witcher side of things, we got a series called The Witcher. Now, The Witcher has been out a bit longer, and it does now have a Season 2, and I believe a Season 3 is in production, but the Cyberpunk Edgerunners has literally just released, and that just has the one season at the moment. First of all, let's go in depth in The Witcher. Now, The Witcher is based before the video game series. Now, they don't completely link up, but if you were to put it somewhere in a timeline, it would just be before the games. Now, at the moment, we have three Witcher games, those being Witcher 1, Witcher 2, and Witcher 3. And about 5 years after the most recent Witcher game released, we did get the first series of The Witcher franchise. When The Witcher first came out on Netflix, just the first season, it's got over 142 million hours streamed in its first 3 days. Now that is some good numbers. And it was also in the top 10 rating list for the week of December 13th to 19th when it had released. Now this is very impressive, and it is nice to see. We haven't really seen video games take off on the whole TV side of things. Now personally, I would love to see other companies do what CD Projekt RED have been doing, and that's pushing some of their popular titles over to Netflix, and this has worked really, really well. There has been a few other companies that have tried a few things, but they've never really taken off as much as this has. Something that I do think is really impressive is that it has brought users over from Netflix over to the video game series and just got them overall interested in the franchise. Now, of course, it was expected that people from the PlayStation, Xbox, and PC side things that played the games would go ahead and watch the series. That was expected. But those expectations certainly weren't as high for when it comes to Netflix users going over to play the games or read the books. But it did work out nicely. It got users that were just watching the show on Netflix and hadn't really heard anything about The Witcher before, and they enjoyed it, and then they go ahead and they played through the games. And this was actually seen a fair bit. I even know a few people that have done this. So this was clearly some great marketing for CD Projekt RED. It does just bring more life to the entire Witcher franchise. This series on Netflix was so successful that a season 2 was then released a year later, and now a season 3 is also in production. So it's clear to see that it is possible for video game companies to then partner with Netflix companies and then create a brilliant show that then brings players over to the video games or players from the video games over to the Netflix series. It's just a great way to promote the franchise. Now, clearly CD Projekt RED realized this and they then continued it. Like I just mentioned, they did make a season 2 and are now working on a season 3 of the Witcher series, but they then announced a new series completely separate to The Witcher, and that is Cyberpunk Edgerunners. Now, Cyberpunk Edgerunners is going to work a little bit differently to how the Witcher Netflix series did. Now, this is actually an anime. They partnered up with an anime team and then began working on a new Cyberpunk-themed anime series. And this is a 10-episode series, so that's nothing to complain about. Not only did CD Projekt RED release this anime series, they also released a new update for Cyberpunk 2077, and that is the Edgerunners update. So this has the same name as Cyberpunk Edgerunners, and this is just a nice way to link the two together, and it brings people over from the game to Netflix, and the people from Netflix over to the game. Now, this new Cyberpunk Edgerunners update, the patch 1.6 for Cyberpunk 2077, was slightly Edgerunners themed. It did bring some new secrets related to the Cyberpunk Edgerunners anime series to be discovered in Night City. This did also include new equipment and even new photo mode features, which was really nice to see. This wasn't really expected to be part of the patch 1.6 update. Now, of course, this wasn't all that was added with patch 1.6. We got 3 new gigs, new weapons, cross progression, a new arcade game, and of course, loads of patches. So not only did this update improve Cyberpunk 2077 and bring a bit of new content, but it did also promote the Edgerunners Netflix series, which was just planned to release about a week later after the patch 1.6 had released. This gave players time to play through the new update and then watch the new series when it released. They didn't overboard people with it all releasing at the same time or anything like that. They spaced it out really nicely, and they even announced a new DLC for Cyberpunk that releases next year, but we won't really go into that in this video. Now, in terms of how Cyberpunk Edgerunners is performing on Netflix, since it did release a couple days ago on September 13th, it has actually got a 100% Rotten Tomatoes score, which is really, really impressive, and it has also broken into the top 5 on Netflix. So of course, with the help of the Edgerunners update in Cyberpunk 2077, this series definitely hasn't gone unnoticed. So that is just about all I wanted to talk about in this video. I just wanted to have a bit of a discussion video about the Witcher series and also the new Cyberpunk Edgerunners, and just how CD Projekt RED have linked things up really nicely with Netflix and how it's generally just helped promote their franchises. And I really do think that this is something that other game companies should start doing, since it clearly works. I would love to hear your thoughts on this down in the comments, and if you'll be watching the new Cyberpunk Edgerunners. I have to say, if you haven't already, I really do suggest watching the Witcher Netflix series and also Cyberpunk Edgerunners. They are definitely, definitely worth a watch, and you probably have Netflix. If you don't, then it's something I definitely suggest investing in. Now, this was a slightly different type of video to what I would usually make on this channel, so I'd love to hear your thoughts on it down in the comments and if it's something you'd like to see more of in the future. If you enjoyed this video though, please be sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any content just like this. And if you are interested in starting your very own Discord server, then hit the link in the description or the pinned comment. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.